Hey, don't talk me. Ha ha no.
Good morning, Credibles Masters and Kartik. You asked us to change the spectacle because I have only one. So I removed it. Our speech topic was, we were trying to find out topic for the humor speech itself. You know, how do we contest and what topic we can find. So we started listing what are all the topics we have, we can use our ideas for humor speech contest. Then we finally found there are about 10 plus CC 10 speeches we got, which is inspiration speeches. That's what the level of thought process went ahead. The next one we got was about, let's do something which Kartik already told, let's list all the problems. We started listing, you know, I did not able to come to the meeting in the morning, and I had a credit card problem, everything I have, and I have a problem at home. Finally, when I was looking for an inspiration, listing all this problem, I myself wanted to have an inspiration from outside, because I have so many problems in life which I am trying to find a solution. You can also laugh, okay? So finally, the problem was about finding a topic for a humorous speech, and finally we thought, rather than seriously preparing for a humorous speech, I thought we can change the costume and everything and attire and everything. I thought we'll humorously start preparing instead of seriously preparing for a humorous speech. And finally we found two solutions. One is solution number one, rather than finding out the topic for humorous speech contest, we found 15 plus more pathway speeches, which is anywhere we can fit in and do an inspiration speeches also. And why not we take a break and don't contest itself, because there is no content, we got it. We'll judge the others and see a content for the upcoming speech.
Own your specs.
What happened just now?
So much else I didn't understand. Take a break. You wanted to contest as if you are contesting for more than 6 years and you are taking a break, you were mentioning. Okay. There is a problem and solution here.
Solution, not to contest.
Solution is, don't contest, be a judge.
Who is from number 2? Jen?
Good morning.
Good morning.
When I join Wipro with a bunch of my batchmates, there will be one idiot in every batchmate. We got a mail from my Wipro bus. Okay, so it was a 225th meeting flyer for in Wipro. That idiotic friend make all our friends to go to that meeting. Hey, come da. There is free samosa and cool drinks. Okay, we also hungry at the 4 o'clock. We will also jump into the meeting. At the 225th meeting, there are only 10% sitting in the meeting. Another 10% added, so totally 20 people were added into the meeting. When the TTM is calling for table topic, none of the people started to get up. So the Toastmasters made the day. Like, everybody started to serve a single person, and that was me. Everybody started to clap hands, everybody started to see at me, and they make me to move to the stage. That happened in Toastmasters meeting, 250th meeting. Finally, I came near the stage and I started to tremble with fear. I don't know what to do, everybody is staring at me and laughing at me and giving a huge smile as if I am going to say something new to them. Then what happened? Something came into my mind, and whatever topic they gave to me, I thought irrelevant, and then also I got a prize because none of the contestants came into the table topic. Finally, that year got out of table Toastmasters, and I joined Toastmasters and continued. And I continue my career in Toastmasters. Thank you.
So what is the problem?
Sarathi.
Come. So third. What is the problem?
He
was preparing for it.
Actually, I was thinking for a very long time how to write a humorous script. It never come to me. But I wanted to bring the scenario in one of the speeches, maybe in the later part of my Toastmasters journey. Whenever you meet someone, you call them, hey, come home, da. But they never say when, what time. Just it's a formality. So So there are a lot of formalities questions when we meet people. And you meet someone in the temple, oh, you've come to temple. Oh, you're in a restaurant, huh? You're going to eat food. So these are the type of questions. Sometimes it is very embarrassing. Yeah, I've come to a restaurant. Of course, we were standing in the restaurant. We wanted to give that sarcastic reply, but these are the points maybe we wanted to, you know. I personally feel that we can bring in a script with humor. So as of now, that's my point of view. Maybe she wanted to add.
To continue with JC, we have one more formality, very formal question. Hi everyone, how are you all? So how often do we use this cliche question? So wherever you see people, and what I mean, I personally experienced once that I went to a hospital. Why do you go to a hospital? Other than maternity. That's the only happiest thing that happens in a hospital. Otherwise, why do you go to a clinic or a hospital? I met one of my relatives there. And I was surprised that she's also there. Hey, hi. She immediately asked, how are you? I had no other option than to say I am fine. But I was not really well. Then why do you even go to a hospital? And I shouldn't blame her because I do that now as well. Because if I have to get a role player, I immediately ping that person and say, hi, how are you? I don't even wait for that reply. And I say, can you please take up evaluation for this? Is he fine? That becomes a very normal question. Don't even wait for the answer. So probably we can kind of be true to the question or kind of probably avoid it. So that was one other cliche question that we came across.
Very nice.
Thank you.
So how many of you are going to contest your numerous speech?
Question say the answer.
So pretty simple, look at the problem and dot it. Okay. So next, in numerous speeches, body language and vocal variety, that's what they say, and I'm sure everybody is pretty familiar. My thing, I used to follow, after writing the script, read it again and again and again, understand what is that emotion you want to convey. Pretty simple. What is that emotion you want to convey? In my speech, when I said Sergeant at Arms is looking for cover and carry bag, it is like poor fellow, poor fellow. And finally you hold it and hold it like you are feeling that the problem is solved. It was like Vijayakant. So that's what you understand that emotion and add it. Read the script again and again and again. What is that emotion you want to convey in that place? Whether it has to be arrogance or you are feeling pity, that you know what has to be done. So it will come automatically in your body language. No need for gestures, all that. It has to come in your DNA. Okay, pretty simple. And next thing, I learned during the process of contesting. One is spontaneity. That always gives an edge with other contestant. You might have seen in division contest, I used that speech of Kaishika Rodrigo. And she was telling, I wore a sari, and when she was walking for opening ceremony, she tripped and fell over on the floor, and she was telling that. And straight away went on to the stage, it is for unisex costume, lungi is unisex costume. Not everyone can wear, men, women, Kaishika, you will not trip on the floor because of this lungi, you can fold and safely you can drop. So it helped, and even people reacted. And in semi-finals, there was something happened, very helpful for my speech, the yellow shirt.
Yes.
People were asking me, Vidya Prashant, after the contest, he was asking me, I know it is already planted, no? Jayan, you, Subhadeep, and all these guys are traveling together, and he is going to be the MC. It was already planned, and you guys are coming on stage and making sure yellow shirt is coming, and he is doing that in MC, and you are using in semi-final so that you are having edge. Not at all. It happened on spontaneously. It happened, and I used it in my speech. It rippled to reverberation. Nothing I said. Yellow shirt. That's it. The audience were reacting to it. And finals, the same way. The guy who spoke on target speaker, he was talking about jogging and very stuffy, and I was telling him lungi will be breezy, man. So spontaneity, catch it from the meetings and use it in your speech. That will give an edge. And the other thing is no, you were looking at me, I felt at the time, is familiarity. When you are familiar as a speaker, you don't need to establish for that 30 seconds to make sure audience are connecting to you. That connect will be happening immediately. So in my semi-finals, my mentor was telling you are pretty familiar across, so you have wonderful advantage. But for finals, he gave one idea. Fun night, in our semi-finals, only two Sri Lankan divisions were there, and only 50 people were there. They were league divisions, only 50 people were there. So they are not familiar with you. And remaining 181, 200 people were there in the finals. So make sure they are connecting to you. So for that, what we can do, fun night we'll go. Have a flashy costume, flashy lungi, red or some yellow flashy lungi and a flashy shirt. Wear shades. Don't worry if it is night or not. Wear shades. Walk around to all the Sri Lankans and ask this question in Sinhalese. Osa kohomada endume. Osa kohomada. I did not bother whether they respond or not. I went to all the Sri Lankans in fun night when everybody was enjoying. I went to all the Sri Lankans. Osa kohomada endume. With the shades, whether not, what is the reaction? Osa kohomada endume. Osa kohomada endume. I was asking all the Sri Lankans. In finals, when I walked in and said, Osa kohomada endume, there was one guy sitting in the left, Swarutesh, and he was reacting. Oh my god, that's why I was asking yesterday to everyone. So there was a connect immediately. So no need for a speaker to go and establish. Do whatever you want to become familiar in the contest. Make sure you go. Shubdeep, you don't know this guy. You go early. When somebody walks in, hey, how are you? Nice shirt, man. Very beautiful. That's it, pretty simple. Hey, beard is beautiful. When you go on stage, hey, this guy complimented me. Yeah. So they will already, hey, this guy, I spoke to him in the morning, he complimented me. So you will have that connect, that familiarity will give an advantage as a speaker when you walk in. And what else can be done to hit the audience? To hit the audience mind. What else can be done? Jay. Connect. We spoke about that in last week's. The problem, whatever I said, right? The problem when you are listening, everybody will go through. The script itself will have that connect. You write the problem and you will feel this will be connecting to them. This will be connecting to them. That connect is very important. Like any speech I write, after the speech, I feel whether they will connect to it or not. If you feel there will not be any connect, just scrap it. Just scrap it. Like, you have to feel that when you close your eyes, you have to feel that audience will be laughing to what you're going to speak. So if you don't feel that, don't write that script. Straight away, change to the other problem. Change to the other. Sometimes this problem, there is a problem, and how you go through, and how others go through, and what is the solution will have a better ripple in the script. When you deliver, what is it you are looking for, Shankar?
No, I am
going to continue. So, I have another 5 minutes. If you have any questions, we can discuss. 4 minutes.
I have a question. So, you said that the problem and the solution. In fact, when you go through the list of problems, so all that has to be humorous, isn't it? That one question I have is all the list of problems, how do we deliver it humorously? Because for me, even small petty thing is a problem. Driving a car is a problem. Meeting a girl is a problem. So how do I deliver it?
That's it, pretty simple. Driving a car is a problem.
No, but okay, I go and say it to Anderson audience. For me, driving a car is a problem. What is the humor in that? What driving a car is a problem is not at all humorous. So, but how do I express that humor? So that's my question.
That's what. See, you go through that. What is that problem you face when you are driving the car?
Problem is I was not able to see the left hand mirror properly, and I do not have the sync between the steering and the gear.
No, that's a pretty simple. I don't have hand and eye coordination. That's it. So it is already working out. No?
Most of the time, I have the perception that it will not work on the stage. If I go and say that, okay.
Make an attempt. So it will.
And again, to add to that, one more question I have. So the solution, if something I have a serious message to tell, is that okay to be added in a human research article?
Sometimes okay. And for me, audience has to leave in high. I'll not deliver message.
No, even when I say a serious message, even then the audience will feel high. But will that work for a humorous speech as maybe as a judge perspective, from judge perspective?
What is your perspective?
Humorous speeches need not have a message, says the rule book.
No, I'll not go for a message.
Go for it, Ashutdeep. Come on.
I'll not look for a message. All I want is enjoy the speech. At the end, I have to feel, wow. For that 7 minutes, I have to forget everything. Even in ISE also, 7 minutes, I should not think of anything. Only I need to stick to it.
Yeah.
That's it.
Yeah. From audience point of view, I think you can have a message, but it should end on a humorous note. It should end with a serious message.
For the spelling.
So many jokes are just one-time funny. So if the same audience comes to the next round and they listen to it, they don't laugh.
Yes.
That is one part. The others, to the speaker themselves, they know when they are writing the script it is funny, but when delivering it the humor drops over time. So how does one actually tackle that?
For my script, when I decided I want to contest and this is the concept, I sat with one of my club member and wrote 25 ideas about Lungi, how it can help Toastmasters. 25 ideas I written, and out of which I worked only 13 in the script. Remaining were failed miserably in club. And for example, one idea I used it in semi-finals, one idea I did not use in finals. And there are places where audience will be looking for that joke. They would have seen in division and they will be telling the friend, hey, Bara, something is going to come. They will be looking for that joke. Sometimes it will help and sometimes it will not. And at that point you need to switch for some other jokes. You need to have a lot of ideas, so that you can shuffle and use it in your script.
Yeah, I think that's a very valid question. Meaning, I'll just cite your example. Your semi-final title was?
You are the future of Toastmasters.
Huh?
You are the future of Toastmasters.
You are the future of Toastmasters. For the finals, the title was changed. It was Guru Guru Guru.
Yeah.
So what happened when the title was announced, everybody thought that he's going to deliver a new speech. So they kind of erased the expectation of the semi-final and they kept looking for new things. But it was the same old stuff. So that way you can kind of rattle the expectations so that they be prepared for it.
And also I just shuffled the
scenarios.
And added few things and removed few things. That's what I did.
I think one question. For humor, our own experience always will rock. So we'll have the credibility. But all the time we will not get our own ideas for humor. Sometimes we borrow from internet or something like that. Would be the consequence of that?
Don't do that, sir. You will not be justifying that completely. It's my opinion. If you borrow it, you will not justify to 100%. You may do it, but it will not have connect.
Also, there might be a problem of originality.
Originality.
Chief gents.
I'm talking in favor of the speaker.
I have a should we always make ourselves in a vulnerable position for it to be humorous? Should we always embarrass ourselves by citing problems, or is there a different way altogether? I think a lot of people don't come up for humorous speech because they find themselves to be vulnerable, maybe.
No, it is not always you should be. See, I said no problem, and make others feel that because of this problem, how others are suffering. You don't need to be in this corner. You can put others also in this corner, but make sure they are not.
I think I have a question.
Final question.
Sorry. Mm-hmm. Last time when you played the role of a humorarian, mm-hmm. you said you gotta think like Kamal Haasan, but deliver like Kamalamani, sorry. That's very difficult.
Meaning think like Kamal or deliver like
Kamal? Some people thinking like Kamal comes naturally, but some delivering like Kamalamani. But that marriage between the two is very difficult. How do you suggest that?
As I mentioned, that connect, I mentioned the same thing. See, when you deliver this, whether they will understand. See, 90% of the audience, with respect to humor, they shouldn't be complicated. They should not think. It has to be pretty simple, plain. If it is like Kamal Haasan, it will not work. That's why I was telling it. You need to think like Kamal Haasan, but deliver like Kamal Haasan.
Why don't you give an example of what happened yesterday?
Yes. In Wipro, I was delivering a joke. I used it before, and sometimes it worked, sometimes it failed miserably. I gave this, in English I had difficulty, even now I have difficulty. And there was, in 7th standard, ma'am was asking, drawn a triangle, and she was asking, what is this value? How do we, what is that value? And everyone was answering, I know ma'am, I know ma'am, I know ma'am. And even the guy who was sitting next to me was a rank holder. I was looking at him, you know, ma'am, yes ma'am, yes ma'am. I was shouting. See, nobody's coming. So it took time to, that's what it is like. I was telling them, no reaction from the audience. I was looking at the audience and it took time. I immediately told them, always jokes has to be delivered like, think like Kamala Hassan, delivered like Kamala Mani. I think like Kamala Hassan and delivered like Kamala Hassan. It took time to understand. Then people took, oh, that is what you are trying to do. So that is it. It is difficult in many jobs. Okay, thank you so much.